Hey guys, Matt here in the boat, and I wanted to take a few minutes and show you a few modifications I made here to my shad tank, bait tank, herring tank. There are a lot of tanks out there. There's a lot of really good choices right now. You know, way back in the day, there was only a handful, one or two. And I got this tank many years ago. It's a bait caddy tank that they don't make anymore. But the video is not really about the tank. It's just some of the modifications that I've done because I think that some of these may help some people out there. Not toot my own horn, but I fish a lot of different places. And matter of fact, we've caught striped bass in 14 different states in over 60 bodies of water last time I kind of counted. So doing that, you can imagine the different types of bait and different, you know, conditions that we've had to keep bait alive in. So anything from sardines to, you know, to mackerel and anchovies, river herring, American herring, hickory shad, I mean, you name it, you know, gizzard shad, thread fins, alewife herring, bluebacks, the whole deal. So I've really learned a lot. And the reason there's so many modifications to this tank is because of all those different types of baits and different conditions, you know, 100 degree air temperatures and 90 degree water temps. And you can imagine all the difficulties that come up with that. So these are some of my modifications. These don't need to be done to every bait tank. For some people, it's in some of their areas they fish, they don't need anything like this. But I wanted to share some of these because maybe one of the two might help you guys. So we'll go ahead and start with the water here. Our water pumps here. Kick that on. This tank here filters from the top. So you have these filter baskets. So it drops the water from the top, and it kind of helps the ammonia leave the tank as gas. But, you know, a lot of tanks don't have that. But what I want to show you is a little modification I made that you can do to pretty much any tank. Now, if you ever try to keep skipjack herring alive or really big baits, some baits that require a lot of current or helps at least a lot of current, kind of keeps them steady on one side of the tank. This is a good way to add current, and I can control it. So hopefully you can hear me over the pumps. All right, you can see the directional flow. That directional flow, I can control that by sliding this. I can reduce it, stop it all together. And that's really good if you need a lot of current, but you don't want so much current that you exhaust your baits. Some baits get tired really quick and you'll kill them, so you don't want that current wide open all the time. So that was kind of cool. Just a little sleeve I put on there. I drilled a few angular holes in that supply line right there, and there you go. Now, I have two pumps going. This tank is two 11-gallon an hour tanks. Huge pumps. I know they're way too big, they're loud and everything else, drain a lot of battery. But the way I have it wired is, I have two running right now. If I hit this, only one is going. And furthermore, I can control the speed of that pump. I can dial it all the way back to just a trickle. Or I can go wide open. And that's this little knob right here. So it gives me more options. You know, when I go ahead and dump a big load of gizzard shad in here, they slide all down the net, the scales and the slime all get stripped off. You dump it in the tank and immediately all that string is hanging in there and it fills up their gills and kills them. So when I put my bait first in there, I'll put both pumps on, crank them wide open and let it run like nuts to get all that initial stuff out. And then I can dial it back as the day goes on, especially when you get down to 5-6 baits, maybe a dozen baits, whatever. You don't need both pumps going. I can go all the way down to, I don't know, 1 gallon an hour maybe. I don't know if I take it all the way down. So that's just another cool little option. You can hear the change. And what that is, it's a motor dimmer switch. It's a 12-volt motor dimmer switch. And I've had a few of these going for years and they've done really well. I wasn't sure if they were gonna hold up, but this one here is probably going on maybe 10 years right now. So works pretty good. Now, I've also added air pumps in here for situations where I don't want to run you know, the water pumps all the time, or I don't need to, or whatever. But it's a similar system. Right here, I got my air pumps. Now I can kick those on, and I have diffusers in the bottom. Now they take a little while to get going. Look, you can see the pumps. I added blue dye here so you can see it better. I hope you can. I don't know if this helps. But there are two on each side. And I also have a switch that I can go down to one pump if I want. And you can see this one has kicked off and just those are running. You can also put a dimmer switch on there too if you want to dial that back. These are my filter baskets here. What I've done is found over the years just seems to be the quickest, easiest way, and does a really nice job. Is on the top I have kind of a scale catcher here. It's just a really coarse Scotch-Brite, and then I have the finer Scotch-Brites stacked. So I mean, you could stack as many as you want. You can go all the way to the top if you want. You can add charcoal and, you know, all kinds of different options you can use with this. Now it's not a giant filter area, so you know, it can clog quick, especially if you put a lot of big gizzards in here, but the two of them, you know, and all this filtration with these pumps running heavy duty, I can run water through them quick, do multiple changes and get it out. You know, some tanks today have a lot of filter material. This doesn't have quite as much, but I like that it's on top of the tank. And back when I got this tank, a lot of the tanks that were available, or the few that were available, they didn't measure water capacity in the bait holding area. It was basically the entire tank. So if you bought like a 50 gallon, your bait only swam in maybe, I don't know, 32 gallons or whatever. Maybe it's 8 gallons in the filter section or whatever. So that was another reason I liked this tank, was because this is a 50 gallon and the bait swims in all 50. I know a lot of tanks today, they've changed the way they measure the gallons. You know, if it says 50, that means the bait swims in it. So there are a lot of good tanks out there. I've noticed some, the new Extreme tanks look pretty good. The Evolution looks nice. The Shad Shack is nice. I know the Creek Bank has been around a little while and doing well. And of course, the old Blue Wave tanks and the Super Bait tanks and Ron Best tanks are around. There might be a few other ones too, but there are a lot more options now than there were. So some of these modifications can be done to those tanks. It may be a little trickier, a little different to do it, but I think if you need stuff like current, or you like to be able to dial your exact, you know, current level, because with this dimmer switch here, this motor dimmer switch, I can control my current even more. I mean, I have lots of options. I can use both pumps at once. I can use just the one. I can dial that one way back. I can slide those sleeves over to cover the holes, so I can get the, you know, the current exactly where I want. And you know, as your battery dies during the day, you want to control it, and I can use just enough power, you know, just the amount of power that I need, instead of, you know, having two or three pumps running all day long and you only have 8 baits left, you know. So hopefully this help you guys out. If you have any comments or questions, you know, put them down in there. I can maybe help you find where I got these. I don't have links or anything, but I can see if I can find those for you. If you have any questions, put them in the comments. If you like the video, give me one of these. If you hate it, you go ahead and give me one of these if you want. I appreciate any comments. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. I love you guys. Mean it. Thanks. Stay safe out there.